Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of Creating Process. In today's video, we're going to look at how you can create also amazing text effects and a graphic design using transform option in Adobe Illustrator. We're going to create all these three designs using transform option. In the previous video, we have used transform option to create all these three designs. During the process, we have learned how you can use scale transform horizontal. We have used move horizontal and vertical. We have also used appearance option to give some gradient look to the strokes. And lastly, we have also used transform shear option to give this perspective look to your design. In this tutorial, we're going to create all these three designs. In the first design, we're going to use the transform scale horizontal vertical as well as move option. For the second design, we're going to use a scale transform horizontal, move transform horizontal, and we're going to understand how we can use the rotate option, which we have mentioned in our previous tutorial. In this tutorial, we'll be concentrating on rotation, so we'll talk about how you can use the rotate option and the other attributes. And lastly, we're going to look at how you can apply this effect to any graphics or any shape design you want to apply. Like over here, I have used some circles and created a design. Then I have used scale horizontal vertical option as well as move horizontal vertical option to get this interesting design. So let's begin with the designing process. So let's understand how we can create out this first design. So it's very simple. We're going to use the text tool. So text tool, type it out and type M, right? And let's give it a, let's say, gray color just to see, right? And after that, over here, as you can see, we need outlines. So to give this outline to this text, we're going to use the appearance option. So I'm going to remove the fill color from here, right? And after that, I'll go to appearance, and first of all, I'll add a stroke, okay? Then I'll add a fill color. And as you know, over here, the stroke and the fill layer can be adjusted later on. Like if you want your stroke to be on top, you can do it, or if you want to place it on bottom of the fill, you can place it there. So right now, let's change the fill color to black, and let's change the stroke color to something a little brighter, and let's increase the stroke. As you can see, the thickness of the text is not affected. If I place this fill below, it will affect over here. So what I've done is I have placed the fill on top, and after that I have added the stroke on the bottom, and if you increase it, it will increase it from the back side without hiding the top layer. So we'll keep it around 10 for this design, and okay, something like this. Let's scale this up a little bit, and I'll change the thickness to 10. So the font is Avener next, and it is bold. And now let's apply the effect. And to create this effect, we're gonna use the transform option. So I'll go to effect, distort and transform, and transform. And under transform, let's begin. So first of all, I'll increase the number of copies to something around 5 just for now. And let's try to recreate this. So it's going up. So I'm gonna give some like this much and this much, and as you can see, there is something wrong going on, and that's because we have selected only the stroke color in appearance panel. You have to select the overall shape. So I'll just cancel this, and as you can see, it's only selecting what, only the stroke color. What you need to do is you need to select outside, click outside, and that way it will select the whole text. If you select individual layer, and if you try to apply the transform option, it will be applied only to that layer. So right now we need to be applied on both the layers. So I'll just click on outside like this, and it will select the overall text. Now if I go to effect, transform, and transform here, and I'll try to move it on the other side, I just increase the number of copies first, and here we go. And if I move it on that side, you can see it's moving that side, right? And I'll set this number of copies to around, let's say, 7, and let's increase the size, okay? And that way, I'll also increase the vertical points. I'll move it up, something like this. So we'll keep it 10, but let's try to keep it 10, this one also. And I think this is the thickness we want, and I'll click OK. Now, if you want to change the color, you can anytime go in and change it. Like say if you want to change it to black and white, I'll just change the stroke color to white, and here we go. And let's change the fill color to pure black, right? That, and that's how we have created this single text. And if you want to change the font as well, as you can see, this font is Myriad Pro. If you want to change to Myriad Pro, just select this, type out my, yep, here's this, and let's choose some bold one, and let's try to increase the size a little bit, and let's try to adjust the thickness here, 10 points. And here we go. Now let's create this O as well. So I just create a duplicate and place it here. And now we'll change the direction of this copy. So we want this to be on the bottom. And to do that, we'll go to appearance, right? And under appearance, you'll see the transform because it's the copy. So there will be a transform option here. Click on it and you'll open this transform effect. And let's try to edit it. Here it's horizontal, vertical, it's same. What else is we need to just change the negative and positive value. We'll add a negative value over here, and here remove the negative value. This is minus 11, this is plus 11, and if you kick outside, here we go, and here it is. Now I'll just create one more duplicate of this, selecting the both, alt press, click and drag it down. Now let's change the text. So double click here, okay, and I'll just type O. In the same way, I'll select this, press R, then here, press E, and here it is, more. And now I'll just do the placement. So place it somewhere around here, one around here, another around here. And to just check the number of copies, I'll go to transform and let's see if it's 7. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So this is good. This is the number I want. And we have given around 11.5 for each of the angles, horizontal, vertical. And number of copies is 7. And that's all. We have just adjusted the move, horizontal, vertical, and the number of copies. And click OK. And we have created this interesting text effect using transform option. You can edit this text anytime you want, or you want to edit the color, you can do it anytime. So this is the first design. Now let's look at how we can create out this second design, and it's very interesting. It's the design which we have created using the rotate tool. So you can use rotate tool to give some another look to your design. So let's try to create this. I'll just type our text, urban, U-R-B-A-N, urban, and let's fill this up with a little gray color, right? And apply a stroke color to this text. So I'll just apply text. And for this, I don't need anything. I just need a simple effect. So I'll just keep it plain. I'll apply fill color from here. And I'll give a stroke color from here. So I'll just keep it, let's say, greenish. Something like this, right? And the interior, something little darker gray. And here we go. The text is ready. And let's change the font as well. We'll change this to Nexa Bold, N-E-X-A, Nexa Bold, right? And let's increase the spacing a little bit. So go to character and let's increase the spacing a little bit, something similar to that. And here we go, the text is ready. Now let's create this effect, and we're going to use the transform option. So I'll go to effect, transform, distort and transform, and transform. Under attributes, under this attribute panel, you'll first have to do is you have to increase the number of copies. So I'll just increase the number of copies to around, let's say 20, right? And let's try to adjust the value. So I'll just first adjust the move value of vertical. So let's increase the value. So here it is, it's go down. And I want to rotate this. So let's give it a rotation, something 3, huh? This is good. So the rotation is given and the vertical movement is given. Now let's adjust the scale value. So the design which you have created this is using all these attributes together. We have to adjust each of the attributes just to get an interesting look you want. So I'll just reduce the vertical value. As you can see, it's decreasing the distance between the alphabets. I'll keep it around, let's say 95, and here also I'll just move it on the other side, 98, right? And I'll use the horizontal movement as well, just to move it this side, 1, 2, okay, 1, let's see. Okay, it's looking similar. We'll just reduce the height a little bit, something like that, or maybe using this value, something similar to that. And I'll just increase the height and the here movement. And that way we have created this nice look. You can adjust it until you are happy with this, and using this horizontal movement, you can move it on left, right, that's your choice. And as you can see, this is the exact design which you want. The values are around, in horizontal scale, I have given 98, vertical 92. The number may vary as per your design, but for this dimension, I have given the movement 1 point and a vertical 13 point, and the rotation I have given 3 degree. You can increase it to almost everything, like you can create something different design using this. And this can be applied to a shape or anything, which we'll talk about in a later tutorial. For this, we're going to give it to 3 degree. And number of copies, you can increase it for multiple number of times. For this design, number of duplicate around 20 is perfect. So I'll keep it to 20 just to give it a even number. and click OK. So here we go, the design is ready, and you can anytime change the color. The simple, it's black and white, fill and stroke. You can change the stroke by just moving it around and click OK, and here we go, the second design is also ready. Now let's look at this third design, and it's quite simple because it's a basic shape. So you just have to create a shape and then apply the transform effect. So to create this, I'm going to use the ellipse tool. So let's go here and select the ellipse tool and just draw out a circle, simple circle, something like this. And I'll just fill this up with simple color and remove the fill color. So this is the fill color. I have given greenish color, something like that. Now let's recreate this design. So I'll just create a duplicate one, and you can just adjust it as per comment. So that this. Now I'll just duplicate a few more. Place one around here, one around here. So filling up the empty spaces, something similar to this, something like this. And once you are happy with your overall shape here, just filling up the empty spaces. And here we go. Let's say you are finished with your design. I have placed these shapes in this order, and now let's apply the color. So I'll select all this first and group this up, Control or Command G, right? And now it's single object. And now first I'll apply a gradient color. Just double click on the gradient tool and just click here, and it will be applied. And just click and drag and apply a color. Now to adjust the colors, on the left side we want blue, so click on this, double click, and pick a color from here, light blue. And on the other side, I'll just double click on it and pick a yellow color. This is the color from the swatches, so it's here, right? And I have applied it. And to give it an interesting look, I also add one more slider here, and I'll add something greenish, something like this. Okay, and here we go, I have given a color. Now next thing I'm going to do is to apply the transform option. So selecting that, go to effect. Before that, I'll create one more duplicate of this. So select this, Control or Command C to copy, and Control or Command F to paste in front. And I'll just lock this, Command 2 to lock. And we are left with one another copy. So I'll use this copy, right, and apply transform option. The reason I have created that duplicate is because I want one surface on top and another on the bottom. One is for the top surface, which is going to be given a different color, and for the bottom, which is extruded, where the transform effect will be applied, we're going to give some darker tone just to give this depth of field. So that's why we have created a copy. One is locked so that it can't be selected, and another I have selected. Now I'm going to apply the transform effect. So here, the transform effect options is here. And now for this design, we need number of copies first. So I'll increase it to, let's say, 7 or 8 or maybe 10 as per your requirement, but we'll keep it low first of all. And now let's adjust the value. And for this design, our main focus will be here, the scale value. So let's try to adjust the scale value. So I'll just reduce the scale value, and it will coming on the center. In the same way, I'll reduce the vertical value, it will come inside, something like this. So as you can see, it's already giving that look. Now I'll just use the horizontal movement tool just to move it left on right. So as you can see, this is looking great. This is already giving that depth of field look. And here you can increase the number of copies. So we're going to give it around, and let's reduce the height a little bit, something like that. And here, something like that. And let's increase the number of copies, something like this. So overall, I think it's looking fine. This is the design which I want, and I'll click OK. And now let's change the color. Remove this color from here, right? And first color I'm going to choose is dark, so dark blue, something like that. And here on the other side I'm going to choose yellow and make it darker. Yes, so you can see the effect directly affecting our design. And here we go. Now if I go outside, and you see we got that interesting look. And if I press Command Alt 2 or Control Alt 2, you can unlock your first shape, and our second design is on the bottom, which has got that depth of color. And that's how we have created this three interesting design. For the first design, we have used transform option, where we have used the attributes such as scale, move. For the second one, we have used mainly our rotation and the scale and move. That's very important. For the third design, we have mainly used the scale attributes, and something the horizontal movement as well. And lastly, we have used gradient tool to give this interesting color combination. All these texts are editable. You can edit it anytime, as well as the color can be adjusted anytime. And that's how we have created all these amazing text effect designs using transform option. In the next tutorial, we're gonna look at how we can create also amazing graphic design using transform option. We're gonna use the attributes which we have used earlier in such a unique way to create all these amazing designs. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Don't forget to check out the next tutorial coming up. And if you want more updates on designing, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe this channel. Thank you.